Suddenly, I stopped producing breast milk, so now I collect breast milk for my friends. Amy is from my yoga class. Jessica is actually one of my coworkers. Chloe prefers Jessica's milk over anyone else's breast milk. I mean, this is her fave. She'll drink the others, but this is more her preference.
Free breast milk saves Apple over $1,000 a year off the cost of fortified toddler milk.
Having a baby made me more obsessed with saving money. People buy baby wipes, moist towelettes, but instead I like to make them at home.
Okay. There you go, you have moist towelettes. I use this to wipe my hands with it, and or wipe the tables, like my kitchen table, my kitchen counter. This is totally reusable still, so I use the wipe to wipe her bum with.
Apple's homemade wipe saves her 50 cents a day for 6 diaper changes.
A changing table is one of the most expensive things that a new mom has to buy. So instead of spending $200 on a changing table, I got mine for free at a gas station that was going out of business.
I thought it's kind of weird. Things from the gas station aren't clean.
People use changing tables all the time, so why not use this one?
She's also found a way to save $450 on diapers themselves.
Why not use t-shirts to make reusable cloth diapers?
You cut the sides and cut the sleeves off, and then fold the flaps, and there you go.
There's no need for me to use the washing machine because it just costs too much money. I could just reuse the water right here. There's a lot of wear and tear on your clothes in the washing machine. I'm able to wash my clothes in here. My clothes last for years.
From a real estate standpoint, hot tubs are considered personal property and do not affect the resale value of a home.
I just put a little bit of soup in my plastic container, and you'd be surprised at how quickly it heats up. I think people probably use their microwave every day, and that adds up to almost $40 a month. It's almost ready. Because my hot tub's not going to add any value to the house, I decided to use it for multi-purposes, for everything that I can think of. It costs about $15 a month to take a 10-minute shower every day, and that adds up. By using my hot tub, I would say I'm saving about $30 to $40 a month. That way I don't have to use my appliances. I could turn off the hot water heater. This hot tub, I mean, this thing is a money saver. I mean, this is like a cash cow for me. I think it's a stroke of genius myself.
I think that all of Todd's free time is spent preserving the value of things that he has.
I'm planning on selling this car, and I want to try to get the best deal I can. This car is 10 years old, and you would not know that by looking at it.
If I were to sell my car, I think I could probably get $3,000 for fair condition and $6,000 for good condition, easily.
I've got plastic not only on the dashboard and on the steering wheel, but I've got it on the seats, I've got it on the floor mats. Most cars get a lot of that weathered look, and a lot of the sun just bleaches a lot of the plastic, but I don't get that in my car. My car is just perfect. I mean, it's as good as the day I bought it.
I have no idea how Todd is able to drive in that car with all that plastic. He has no pride.
I like to go spin on the little bike to get my workout on. Getting on it and pedaling, I'm just in that zone, and I get burning. You feel the burn? I'm listening to my tunes. It just feels good to exercise, and I just love it.
All right, here's your stuff. I see Jenny probably 2 times a week. When Jenny first came, I thought she was in the market to purchase a piece of exercise equipment. Most customers will come in and demo the equipment maybe 2 or 3 times before making a purchase. All right, thanks, guys. I appreciate it very much. Good luck this season. After 6 or 7 visits, I realized that Jenny wasn't here to demo the equipment.
My habits may be extreme to some people, but I show it off to everybody, whatever it is. It makes me happy. Bye.
Bye.
Instead of going to gyms, I just go to these sporting goods stores for about 45 minutes a day.
All right. Bye.
See ya.
Going to a gym, paying for a membership, I mean, that's like $75 a month. It doesn't cost me a dime to work out in that sporting goods store. I've always been really cheap, and it's just kind of been something that I have always done. I just get a good feeling out of not spending a lot of money, but yet still accomplishing whatever goal I have. I absolutely hate spending money on things that I can't see the next day if it's gone. On the average, most people, they fill up their tanks once, twice a week. It can cost $60, $70 to fill up a tank. And then you go home and park your car in the garage and you may not go nowhere. So you just spent $60 to sit. Hey, can I get $3.36 worth of gas?
You sure can.
When it comes to gas, gas is kind of like makeup. You know, less is more. When you buy less, you use less, and you save more. When I get gas, I only get a gallon at a time. 1 gallon of gas, 1 gallon a day, saves me money. Restricts where I go.
Stephanie's job as a flight attendant keeps her traveling for 20 days a month. But when she's not up in the air, her home is in Dallas, Texas.
My mother used to say, make sure you turn out the light before you leave the room. And of course, nobody pays attention to that until I started paying the bill. Before I leave, I turn off all the electricity at the circuit breaker. Even though I'm not using my appliances, they're still sucking up electricity.
Standby power can draw as much as 250 watts a day from major appliances. By cutting the electricity to everything but the refrigerator, Stephanie saves an average of $30 a month on her electric bill.
When the passengers leave the plane, I go through and check for a meal that's left by a pilot or a passenger.
Stephanie's idea of fine dining is bringing home what the airline's left over. We open up a refrigerator and it looks like a deli.
The food is perishable items. They're gonna throw it away if I don't take it home and eat it. I'm saving myself about $15 on every meal. In first class, they serve mixed nuts. In main cabin, they serve the regular nuts. Now, if they're unopened, you're not allowed to take them. But of course, if they're open, I bag them up, I bring them home. A jar of mixed nuts is about $8. I don't have to pay for them. They're good for snacking, and they're really good for protein.
That's nasty. I don't know what to tell you.